Hello and welcome all. Today we are going to look at a mosquito killer. How this mosquito killer is working and what is the circuit inside this mosquito killer. So I have drawn the circuit diagram of this and we will see it now. This is the circuit of this mosquito killer. This is the circuit diagram of the mosquito killer, and there is a battery is there. As it consists of a battery, there should be a circuit for charging this battery. This is the circuit for charging the battery. This circuit uses the voltage dropper method to charge this battery. That means this capacitor, the polished capacitor, is used to drop the excess voltage. And there is a transformer is there, and there is a switch is there. This, when we are charging, we are putting it to one side, and when we use as a mosquito killer, we shift the button to other side, and this is the push button. When we are pushing this button, it is working, and there is a transformer is there. This transformer is used to boost the input voltage. This battery voltage is boosted by this transformer. Transistor is there. This transistor and the transformer together brings the voltage up. And there is a AC to DC converter. And this is not only AC to DC converter, but also a voltage doubler. It does the purpose of voltage doubling, and also act as a AC to DC voltage rectifier. Now we will check the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram of the mosquito killer. There is the AC is coming. We are connecting the AC, and this is the LED. 230 volt is there. This, if we say that this LED is working 3 volt, the remaining voltage will be dropped across it. Similarly, we have to charge this battery. So a charger is needed. So we are using a dropper circuit, voltage dropper circuit, to charge this battery. The working of the voltage dropper is, when this is a polyester capacitor, that means this has a certain reactance or resistance. Reactance means resistance, a resistance at a certain frequency, and according to the current that we wanted, we select the value of the capacitor. That means at our input frequency is 50 hertz. That means at that frequency it offers a very high resistance, and the voltage, 230 voltage, most of it drop across it, and the remaining voltage, around a 4 volt peak to peak voltage, is available there. It is rectified using a bridge rectifier, and it is connected to the battery. That means a 4 voltage is available at this point, and the battery is charged. During the charging, this switch is not connected to the output, so the battery will get charged. There is a transformer is there. This is the transformer. This is the transformer. And how is it working? This transformer is working on the basis of the principle of dual thief. What is dual thief? Dual thief means, just look at the circuit. Here we are connecting the battery, the plus side of the battery and the minus side of the battery. This is the main winding, and the main winding is connected to the collector of the transistor. And from the same point, there is another winding is there. These windings polarity will be opposite to each other. That means polarity is opposite to each other. When we press the push button, that means the battery voltage is available between these points. Now, what happened is that when the battery is connected, there will be some current will flow through the circuit. When a voltage is appearing here, there is a small current from this side to this side is flowing. So due to this there is that means there is a small base current is flowing from the ground from this side to this, or from the electron flow from this side to the positive side of the battery. That means a current is flowing. When the current is flowing, beta times current will be flown through this circuit. This circuit means from this side to this side through the collector to the battery. That means when this much of current is flowing, there will be, that means a rate of change of current is happening. Due to that rate of change of current, flux is generated. When there is a change in flux, the polarity of this become, this polarity is will be like this, plus and minus here. And due to the winding is in opposite direction, this polarity will be minus and plus here. This polarity will be like minus here and plus here. That means this is plus and this is minus and this is plus. That means the voltage at this point is adding. As the current through this increasing, the flux, change in flux inside the core is increasing. This change in flux introduce a more voltage at this point. This voltage causes more current to flow through this. So the transistor become more open and more current, more and more current will be flowing through this circuit. And after a particular point, core becomes saturated. Core becomes saturated means it has reached to its maximum value. If more current is increased, there will be no change of flux. That is, it reaches maximum flux density. So by flowing more current, it don't have any action. That means there is no change in flux. As there is no change in flux, there will be no voltage is developed across it. As there is no change in flux, and this inductor wants to keep the current constant, its polarity become now reversed. Polarity become, this become minus and this become plus. That means now it is opposing this battery voltage. Now it is opposing the battery voltage. So the current will begin to reduce. That means when the current through this is increasing, when the current through this is increasing, this is the current that is increasing. After reaching a particular value, the core gets saturated. That means if more current goes through this, there will be no change of flux. So there is no change of flux means this point does not have any voltage due to this. So in order to maintain its voltage, it reverses its polarity and opposes the battery voltage, and now the base current began to fall. If we say that it is the base current and it is increasing, after it gets saturated, the polarity of this will become reverse, and now it becomes to in the reverse direction. As the current to the base is reversed, the current through this will also decrease, and after a particular point, the current through it will be fully off and there will be no more current. When it is reversing the polarity also, when it is reached its maximum value, the polarity will be reversed, and here also the polarity will be reversed and current will flow through this. That means according to the flow of current like this, the voltage is also at the output is also, this is a more number of turns are there though, so the voltage at this point will be very high. So the frequency or the oscillation is determined by the value of the inductor and flux density, that is the maximum flux that it can handle. It depends on the two things. That means if the value of the inductance is very large, the rate of change is very low, so it takes more time. If the inductance is very high, that means it will take more time. That means that rate of change of current is like this. If the inductance is high, the rate of change of current is like this. That means the rate of change of current means according to the time. This is time. In this time, the change in current will be only this amount. If low inductance is used, the rate of change will be high. That means for the same time, this much of here, only this amount of current is changed. Here, this much of amount of current is changed. So, by changing this much of amount, the flux also will be very high. The change in flux is also very high. So, the core becomes saturated very early. The time for saturation of flux is very less. So, the frequency, time of saturation is very less means it will be saturated very less time. That means it will be saturated very less time means this will be like this. That means it has a high frequency. If the inductance is high, it will take more time to saturate. So, the frequency will be low. Frequency is determined by the value of the inductance. And according to that, the voltage is available at the output. Now we can see that as the oscillation is determined by the value of the inductance, the frequency is determined by the value of the inductance, this will go on to oscillate. That means here AC is generated. The frequency of the AC generated is depend upon the value of the inductor. Now there is a circuit. As the output here is an AC like this, the voltage is varying. So in order to get a fixed voltage, we have to use a voltage rectifier. That means the AC has to be converted to a DC, and we don't want to lose the voltage. So we are using this circuit. This is a rectifier and a voltage doubler. This has two purposes. It has rectify the AC, and also it is a voltage doubler circuit. How this circuit is working? When a positive voltage is appearing here, and this is ground, that means this will be charged. This is positive. This will be charged through this to this. And what about this capacitor? This capacitor, as this is positive and this is negative, it is reverse bias. There will be no current. So in this cycle, in the positive cycle, this capacitor will charge to the peak value. This is the peak value of the voltage. This is charged with us. In the next cycle, when this become minus, this will be reverse biased. This is positive and it is already charged to Vm. This is plus and this is minus. So this is plus, and when become this polarity become minus, this is reverse bias. When this become negative, this will conduct. This is positive, this point is positive, and this point is negative, means this is also charged, going to conduct like this. And there also the Vm, peak voltage Vm, is charged across this capacitor. So after a full complete cycle, the voltage across this will be 2 Vm. Now from this point we are taking two wires, and from this point we are taking one wire. This is, we can see here that this is the two wire we are taken from one point, and there is a red wire, this is taken from the other side. These two wires, there are three nets are there. Two nets are at the outer side and one net is at the input side. That means when an insect go inside, there will be voltage difference between this point and this point, this net and this net, and in the this side also there will be a voltage difference. So these are the two outer nets, and this is the common point. These are the two outer nets, and this is the common point. Whenever any insects come inside, the voltage across it will be high. So, as the resistance of these insects are very low, a due to the high voltage current flow through this, and it is able to damage them. So
this is how the circuit is working.